I'm literally recording this on my laptop because my. I'm so nervous. Because my card on my camera is full and I'm stupid. So we're doing the laptop. So I'm about to phone interview for the spring 2019 DCP. The last one I have done it before. The last one I did was the DCP 2016. And in about 2 minutes is my 15 minute before my interview where they're allowed to call me. I am so stressed. Anyway, I just wanted to check in and let y'all know what's going on. I might post this, I might not post this. Depends on how embarrassing it is. I'm so stressed. I don't know. Okay, I gotta go. I gotta go. I'll see y'all when it starts, I guess. It better not be late because I'm gonna drive myself insane.
To begin, let the wonder take hold.
Feel it draw you in. Watch the moment unfold.
Spark a dream that we're meant to follow. Setting out for a new tomorrow.
Hi, this is Morgan. Hi, Casey. I'm great. How are you? Perfect. Yes, it's absolutely a good time. Okay. Perfect. Okay, great. Thank you.
Every step we take brings a new hope, new day.
Every choice we make helps us find our own way.
Every wish finally put into motion.
I am still familiar. I do not. All I have is the one piercing in my ears. Yes. Yes. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Yeah. I actually really lucked out. A lot of people go on the Facebook page, and group up with people. And I chose not to do that. So I did just random. And it actually, one thing that crazy surprised me is I'm from Arkansas and I didn't know anybody else from Arkansas that was doing the program. I hadn't seen anybody on the page that was from Arkansas. And it turns out when I moved in, only two other girls had moved in, and one of them was there and one of them wasn't. And she said, "Oh, that girl who moved in that room, she's not here, but she's from Arkansas too." And I was like, "Okay, great. I'll take that room with her." Turns out she lived 15 minutes away from me, and we're still like super great friends. I know. It was the craziest thing. And we're all from small towns, so I couldn't, like, it was just crazy. Never. Well, okay, so my grandma started taking my mom literally the year Disney opened, and it has just been the biggest part of our lives. Like, she went every single year. They took my mom, and then as soon as she had kids. She took all of us. My first trip, I was 2 months old, and we've gone at least two or three times a year since then. I've actually been 45 times, and it's just my whole entire heart, and it's what I want to do for the rest of my life. I want to just work towards pursuing Walt's legacy and just keeping it going, and I love everything the company stands for, and ever since I did it the first time, it was the greatest experience of my life, and I just, my dad said I had to come back and graduate, so I'm doing that, and I'm heading right back, hopefully. Yes, it's been the greatest memories. We are. We are. Yes, we are. Well, I could tell you, my mom said that I didn't go around and meet enough characters because in my head, I'd met them all when I was little and it was fine. And she was like, you didn't get the full experience. But I would probably do that a lot more on this program. But I took classes, you know, and I did everything I could to be involved. And I even extended and got, I had two separate roles. I got to be a lifeguard and merchandise, which I am so overjoyed that I did that because it just gave me an even broader experience in the company. And I just loved every part of it. Yes. Okay. So obviously every time that I tell people I've done the DCP, like they are just so impressed. And so right now I work at a store, and as soon as the interview, I told them like I worked at Disney and just the customer service that they expect, like that's what I loved. And it made me passionate about working, and they were just so excited. And I got that job on the spot, and it's just really helped me. I've actually had two jobs since then. And every time I mentioned Disney, they just got so excited. So I can only imagine that that'll happen after graduation, after maybe the next program in my future career. I can just imagine that they would still be just as excited because Disney is such a respected company. Yes. Yes. So as a junior makeup artist, I wrote on my application that we've worked with little kids. We worked with mother of the brides. We worked with grandmother of the brides. We worked with brides, bridesmaids, every age group. And it's always just so exciting. A lot of times mother of the brides, they've never in their lives had their makeup done. And it's just so rewarding to make them feel beautiful and happy. And you also get to talk to them and learn a lot about them at the same time, because it'd be super awkward if you just sat there and did their makeup and didn't make it a conversation. And I think Disney really helped me with that, because I did learn how to talk and relate to so many different age groups. Like as a lifeguard, I didn't really get to speak to guests as much, you know, you don't have as much interaction. And then when I got to merchandise, I just learned how to make everyone feel special and how to relate to everyone and just be able to communicate better with every age group, no matter their age or anything about them. Right. Well, working in merchandise right now, we have a lot of things like if something accidentally got on the sale rack that wasn't a sale item, people come in, and when you say, oh, the price is this, and they think it was something lower, they might get a little upset. But you just always have to treat people with respect and try to see it from their point of view. And I know Disney is always just make the guest happy, do anything you can, go above and beyond. And that's the store I work at. They've kind of taken over that mindset too. So you always just have to respect and look at it from their point of view. And, you know, they didn't know that it wasn't on sale, and they thought they were getting a really great deal. And you want to try to make that happen for them if you can, you know? Yes. Well, recently, actually, I know I'm from Arkansas, but I live in Mississippi right now, and that's where I work. And we just had a terrible storm, and we actually had our tornado sirens go off while we were working. And we actually have a downstairs to our store, and we had to take all of the customers and take them downstairs. And, you know, some of them might have been older than us. We had adults. We had elderly women and everything like that, but they were looking to us because we were in charge of the situation and we knew the protocols, and we just had to keep everybody calm and just calm them down and reassure them that everything was going to be okay and that we were following protocols and that this was the safest place in the building that we could possibly be. Oh my gosh. Yes. Yeah. Thank you. Yes. Yes, I love having jobs to do. Like, I just absolutely love having jobs to do. If there's a certain thing, like, put back the clothes in the dressing room, you know, just anything that is a job, tell me to do it, and it's going to be done. Yeah. You really just have to prioritize. So right now, finishing school is my number one priority, and keeping those grades up and finishing strong. So that's my number one priority. And then second, of course, is work. And my social life is kind of having to take a back seat, but that's totally okay with me because I know I have other priorities and other people that are depending on me, and I can't show up to work late and I can't, you know, ask off out of nowhere. I just have to respect, again, everyone involved and make sure that I have my priority straight and just do what you got to do. Yes. Yes, ma'am, I do. Arkansas and Mississippi is very, very humid. And, you know, I was in Florida for 7 months in the summer. It was crazy hot. And I was actually just there in August. And I swear, any stitch of makeup you put on is going to be melted off in about 5 seconds. But you just got to go with it and keep a smile on your face. So I think I'm totally comfortable with the weather. Yes. So one time while I was in merchandise, I was actually at Art of Disney. I don't think I put that on my application. As soon as I turned it in, I was like, oh my gosh, I did not even put merchandise at Disney. I'm going to have to tell them. So I was at the Art of Disney in Disney Springs, and this little girl came in, and she was dressed as Elsa, and she just looked at me and like threw her hands at me, and she said, freeze. And I just got to play along with her, and it was just so fun. And I, like, took her around the store and went up to other cast members. And I was like, okay, freeze them. And her mom was just so thankful. We actually had the same name. She was just so cute, and it made her so happy. And her mom just kept saying, oh, thank you so much. And it was just so sweet. And it, as, like, 3 years later, still sticks out to me as one of my favorite memories, is going around the store playing with her. She was so excited. She was convinced she was freezing those people. Yes. 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 Okay, so I really do love makeup. Disney and makeup, you can ask anyone who knows me. Those are my two passions, and they're very apparent. Like, if you talk to me for more than 5 minutes, you're going to know those are the two things that I absolutely love. And the thought of mixing those and getting to do makeup and be a cast member at the same time is just my absolute dream. And while I was at Disney the last time, I met a woman, and she was a fairy godmother in training, and she was just the sweetest thing. And she came in Art of Disney, and we were talking, and she actually, her daughter ended up coming to Mississippi State with me, and I met up with her when her daughter moved in, and now I'm kind of friends with her daughter and see her on campus and I got to show her around, and it was just super cool how those connections, you know, surpassed Florida and surpassed Disney World. And it was so cool. But she just spoke so highly of Bibbidi Bobbidi Boutique, and I applied for it my last program, and it's just always been something I've been so interested in, is making those little girls feel like a princess for the day. And I do have experience doing makeup on children, and I just think I would be really qualified for that, and I think that would be a great fit for me. Yeah. Yeah. Well, they just want somebody to relate to them. You know, they look at us and they're like, oh, adults, scary, when we still feel like kids ourselves. So just get down on their level and remind them. And I can say, oh my goodness, like I was always so scared to get my hair done. I have such a tender head. But I did this when I was young, and just make them seem like it's going to be the most fun thing ever, and say, oh, I'm so jealous you're getting this done, and just relate to them. And they just don't want to feel like they're in a room with a bunch of adults. They want it to feel like the real experience and like they actually are being treated like a princess and that they are a princess. And I just think as long as you relate to them and, you know, comfort them and tell them that it's going to be awesome and you wish that you were getting to sit there in the chair and get all glammed up. And, you know, I think most kids would be super excited after that. Yes, I have had a lot of experience working on a cash register. Actually, Art of Disney was my first time ever working in a cash register. And then when I was a waitress last summer, I obviously had to check people out and stuff like that. And then obviously working in merchandise right now. So I actually do have a pretty good amount of experience on a cash register. Mm-hmm. Yes, absolutely. I do love that I got to work the resort area and I did get to work Disney Springs. I would love to be able to be in the parks because that is where my heart is. My passion is in those parks and I would love to be able to work there, but honestly, I'm comfortable working anywhere. Yes. Well, you know, it's so hard for me to pick, but Animal Kingdom has always had a soft spot in my heart. I'm not sure why. I feel like once I'm at Disney, I'm not at Disney until I go to Animal Kingdom. But then, you know, Magic Kingdom also with the magic and it reminds me of Walt and the statue, and I freaking love Walt. Walt is my idol. But I think Animal Kingdom is like the soft spot in my heart. It's just so intricate and beautiful. Yes, it's so great. And the new Pandora land is so gorgeous. I can't. It is so beautiful. Yes. Yes. Yes, while I was a lifeguard, we had to memorize a spiel to tell all the guests when we were closing and, like, how many minutes till closing and just keep it happy and, like, oh, we're closing the pool, but it's still great. Y'all have 30 more minutes. Y'all better have fun. And I actually love doing that part of it. Yeah. I think a super important thing is, first of all, to remind them that it is for safety, because that is number one in Disney's book, but don't just say, oh, you can't get on this ride and leave it at that. I think maybe have some backup rides in your mind, to that the height requirement is lower that they could go to, and maybe like even pull out a map and show them how to get there so they're just not stuck with anything, like nothing to do. So just give them a backup plan and another place to go and say that ride's even, it's still so great. So that'd be a great option, and just go over there and show them where to go to and don't just leave them high and dry. Oh my gosh, Flight of Passage. Right now, Flight of Passage for sure, 100%. Oh, I know. I know. That is the most breathtaking ride. I cannot. Oh, I get off and I said, I feel reborn. Okay, great. Yes, I am. Oh, yay! Diving in with our hearts wide open. The story comes alive when we look inside. Yes. I know, that was super exciting and helpful. I loved that. Yeah. Yeah, seriously, because like emails you have to go and refresh, but a text message, it just pops up a little happy surprise and it's great. I do have one question. So I took Leadership 101 in Disney Heritage while I was there. Is there any class that you would recommend taking? It's just beginning. Feel your heart beat faster. Reach out and find your happily ever after. Exactly. Lion King is my number one favorite. The part with the bird makes me cry every time. I can't. It is. Yes. It never gets old. It's amazing every single time. That cast is incredible. I do not. You too, Casey. Oh, I have a ton. I could keep going for hours, so you gotta cut me off somewhere. You too, Casey. Thank you so much. Bye. Okay. So let me explain my thoughts. Number one, I feel like that was okay. I feel like it was much more of a conversation than an interview, and I love that aspect of it. I'm kind of scared of that aspect of it because I'm thinking, what, did I make that too casual? You know, you're going to just like question every single thing you did until you find out. And number two, I know I like messed up my words a few times, and I'm not sure that recording myself helped. I was kind of worried about that the whole time, so I'm about to rewatch this thing, hope it's okay, and then maybe I'll record something else to let y'all know. Guys, okay, so it is the next day. It's a full 24 hours later, and I just finished a whole day of work where I couldn't think about it all day. Praise Jesus, because it was crazy. It's the first game day weekend, and it was psycho. So I think I'm just going to share my thoughts, what I've okay, what I have gathered in my brain. Wait. So, first off, I think it went okay. Y'all tell me how you think it went, because you know when you look at yourself in the mirror, you're going to critique literally everything that nobody else even notices or sees or cares about, and you think it's like the biggest issue in the world and everybody's looking at it. Same thing with video and interviews. You think you did terrible and you're going to critique everything. You're going to be like, oh my lord, I paused for 5 milliseconds and I'm not going to get it. So y'all just let me know, because in my eyes, like, I know so many things that I could have done differently. And the last phone interview I had for my spring program in 2016, I remember getting off the phone interview and being like, oh my gosh, I freaking slayed that, honestly. And like, I was pretty confident, and I called my mom and I was like, oh my lord, like, guess it was going to Disney. And that was such a stupid mindset. Don't listen to me. Don't think I'm terrible. I was just stupid. Okay. So, and this time, like, I had fun on the interview. I thought it went okay. I'm not sitting here thinking that I did terrible. I just, comparing the two, it's hard when you've had two, because you're like, oh my gosh, my past one was a little bit better. Does that, what's going to happen? And I think that I'm also worried, because I rewatched it and I thought I was being happy. I thought I was being like, oh my God, which is not, you don't need to be fake. Pause. Let's scratch that. I thought that I was expressing my excitement over the phone, but I rewatched the video and I have a naturally low voice and I'm freaking terrified that it didn't, Okay. I'm just scared you couldn't tell on the phone that I actually was excited, because I do have a naturally low voice, but I'm also hoping that having a southern voice makes me sound sweet. Anyway, I don't know. I don't think I have an accent, but y'all all do. So another thing is that I know I stuttered a few places, and like, I had a great idea going and it was going good, but instead of stopping before I ruined it, I kept going and I ruined it. So like, the question where they were like, how would you deal with a family that the little kid was too short to ride the ride, which, by the way, can't relate, 6 feet tall, never had to deal with that. How would you resolve that problem? And I started out good. I was like, you know, have backup plans for them. And then show them on a map where to go. But then I just had to keep going, and I had nothing else to say. So my mouth was talking, but my brain was like, I have no idea what's happening. And I just kept talking, and my brain shut down. And I think in the video, I literally went, like, what did I just say? I don't know. I'm just stressed. I'm stressed. I'm overthinking it. And I don't need to. So someone help. Tell me your feedback. Let me know how you think I did. I think it was okay. I'm not sitting here trying to rag on myself. I just don't know, because I do have a past comparison and I'm like comparing it to that. And I'm like, I remember getting off the phone and being like, killed it. And this time I was like, might have killed it. I don't know. I will update y'all. And when I find out, I will let y'all know. And y'all will be the, probably not the first, because I'll tell, like, my boyfriend and my parents and my best friend. And so, but y'all find out. You know, I'll update y'all. So, don't worry. And if I do get the program, I really want to just start, like, vlogging and being a Disney account. Because I already have a Disney Instagram. And you should go follow it. It is at Honestly Slay Me. And it's me and my best friend / Little through our sorority. It's our Disney account together. So, let's place it right here. Can I do that? I don't even know how to edit that well. Let's see if that happens. So I'm going to go and try not to think about it for the next 1 week to 3 weeks, or whenever I found out, I will let you know. Until then, see you later. Bye, guys.